Here are 10 basic tips and tricks you need to know to be a better Mac user. I can't be the only one that's tried to copy paste something into a Word document only for it to turn out like this, with some weird font, format, and size. If you press Command Option Shift V when pasting, you can actually paste the text without the formatting. Now this is a pretty basic one, but it saved me so much time. Mission Control allows you to see all your open windows and desktops, especially useful so you can switch through them quickly while you're working. You can access it by dragging up with 3 fingers on the trackpad, or you can set a keyboard shortcut for it. Speaking of dragging stuff, did you know that if you highlight text and drag it onto your desktop like this, you can create an easy text clipping? I didn't know about this one until lately. Next up is the Spotlight tool. Spotlight is one of the great features that the Mac has for finding files and applications, but most people don't know that it can be used for UNIP conversions and calculations. This will take you way less time than just searching it up. If you're ready to take Spotlight to the next level, watch this video on an even better replacement. If you've ever wanted more screenshot options, just press Command Shift 5 and check out the options. You can screenshot a specific window, or a selected portion, or you can even start a recording. Another known but underrated feature is the Do Not Disturb mode. It blocks all notifications, helping you to focus, and you can change your settings, so it allows certain apps and people's notifications if you want. Also, I've made sure to put it in my menu bar so I can access it quickly, which brings me onto my next tip, use your menu bar. Your menu bar is for settings you need a lot, like Bluetooth, sound outputs, user switching, and so much more. You can change what you have in the menu bar in the settings. If you hold Command, you can drag along the little icons. If you're like me and have a lot of things in your menu bar, you can download Vanilla, a free software that allows you to hide some menu bar items, like this, to avoid having a mess. Moving on to some more advanced tricks now. If you use template files, this one will be a lifesaver. If you enable stationary pad like this, every time you open a template document, it'll automatically create a duplicate on your desktop, so your template always stays the same. I've seen so many of my friends with unimaginably messy desktops filled with files, which is why if you don't already, you need to use folders to organize your desktop. But even with folders, sometimes there are just too many folders that you can't recognize any of them. One way to organize your files better is by changing the folder's colors and icons so you know what everything is. To do this, just right-click, go to Get Info, and click on the little thumbnail, and then drag in your selected image. To revert it, just click this. To change the folder's color, go watch this video. Last but not least, we have hot corners. Enable them here, and now when you put your cursor in a corner, you can quickly access your desktop, open the launchpad, or even create a new notes window. I think you'll have noticed in this video that keyboard shortcuts are really important on Macs, and if you want to learn more of them, go watch this video.